Player partner, Pittsburgh P, aka Sir Blue Diamond, aka Jason Print. And I'm back with another episode of Scores and Whores. And a lot more. Boy, oh boy. Damn. Today was a good day. This weekend was a great weekend. I'll get into that a little later on, but yeah, thanks for tuning in. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend, and we're gonna keep it rocking like that. Man, NBA playoffs second round started today. Shit's so fucked up. I work two jobs, I be missing a lot of games. I be catching the highlights though. I'm listening to my little podcast shows. I'm up on everything that's going on. Believe that daddy. But I'm grateful I got to see Boston and Milwaukee game one, and Golden State and Memphis game one. I'm working crazy the next couple days. I ain't got an off day until Thursday night, off all day Friday. Unfortunately, ain't no NBA games Thursday night. It is NHL games. I will be there. Playoffs, NHL playoffs start, but we talking about the NBA playoffs right now. And yeah, it went down today. It went down like a whale in a boat. It went down. Game one, Boston and Milwaukee. I ain't gonna cap. And I should learn my lesson by now. But I thought Boston would win game one. I thought Boston would win the series. I got different thoughts now. Greek Freak had a big game. Not points-wise, he only had about 24, 25 points. 13 boards, 12 assists, triple-double rush face, yeah. Boy, when I got a triple-double first game, and yo, let's keep it a band. Greek Freak, the best player in the league right now. I ain't saying he the best ever, but I'm saying he the best right now. Miss me with the LeBron James shit. Miss me with the Kevin Durant shit, because KD, and no fault of your own. Well, yeah, it was a fault of your own because you had a chance to cease this shit last year. You know, you just happened to have a shoe that was a little too big. And that was your fault because you wore a shoe extra size bigger. You should have had your regular shoe size on. And you know, that two would have been a three. Y'all would have beat them. And yeah, we wouldn't be talking about the Greek Freak at the best in the league. But the Greek Freak is the best in the league. He put everybody on notice today. Like, he on the mission without permission. And I dig it. I dig it with a shovel. For sure. he's saying like he want motherfuckers to know like last year wasn't no fluke. I do it again. This is his thoughts, you know. No Chris Middleton. Don't worry, I got you. Remember, you remember when Kobe did that when the Lakers was playing the Pacers and Shaq's goofy ass fouled out and yeah, people don't, you know, people, Kobe was riding with Shaq, it was Shaq. No, nigga, what about that second year when fucking Shaq fouled out in Indiana and Kobe, young Kobe was like, I got this. Ask Jalen Rose about that shit. You know what I'm saying? So Greek Freak, like, yo, no Chris, you know what I'm saying? That's my Robin. Sometimes my Batman. Sometimes I'm Robin. He ain't here. Don't trip. I got this. Bobby Porter's come up big. Yeah. Jrue Holiday, big game. Big game on the offensive tip and the defensive tip. Jrue Holiday, yeah. It was a real nigga holiday today, for sure, for sure. Cunnington hit some big threes. Pat Cunnington, yeah, he did that. He did that. Bobby Porter's came up big. Jason Tatum. He had a so-so game, but you ain't had one of them games you had in the last round against Boston. Boston wasn't playing no defense. Motherfucking Milwaukee playing defense, but I'm Jaylen Brown, where were you? Marcus Smart had a big game. Marcus Smart had a big game, but the Greek Freak was like, yo, I'm not going out like Willie Lump Lump. Remember when Minister Saddy, Sharif was like, he was talking, him and Kane was in the rap. He was like, oh, Willie Lump Lump. Kane was like, don't worry about it. That's some hood shit. Don't worry about him. Yeah, nigga had the Jimmy. Well, I hope you had the Jimmy on tight, because I know a few brothers that ran for that joint. Damn, Sharif, man. They killed the fuck out Sharif, yo. Sharif said, when I'm a fucking cooler with the 40s in it when they was at the party and shit. Kane said, if you don't get your Lickum Salam ass off that cooler. Oh, I love that movie. Anyway, see, this will have scores and horns and a lot more, because I'd be going, yeah. You ain't gonna get this from Stephen A. Smith. Old funny hairline having ass nigga. I'm gonna fight that nigga, yo. Knock Stephen A. clean the fuck out. But, yeah, anyway, Milwaukee up 1-0. And I'm gonna tell you some real shit, bro. Sis, whoever listening, brothers and sisters. Game 2 is on Tuesday. If Milwaukee win game 2 and they going back to the fucking home of the deer, they go back to deer country where them motherfuckers gonna be going bananas. B-A-N-A-N-A-S. It's bananas. B-A-N-A-N-A-S. Yeah. If they go back to fucking deer country up 2-0. Bostonians. I can't find a broom right now, but the broom might come out. So Boston, I expect y'all to come out and play better in game 2. I expect Jason Tatum to have a Jason Tatum type game. Because Chris Middleton ain't gonna play, but I mean, it's, look, when a motherfucker got championship pedigree, you know, you got a good coach, Mike Budenholzer. He just rallied the troops, and the troops come to play. The troops come to boot up for that guy, you know? You can't coach, you know. I mean, he got some guys that's ready to go. And, Jaylen Brown, you got to step up. Horford, you got to step up. Although Horford, he did have a good game. Time Lord, Robert Williams, you had a good game. I ain't calling you out. Nope. And you got a fucking torn meniscus. Well, you coming off a torn meniscus, and I'm watching the game and I'm watching this nigga jump and get put back to the chair. I'm like, damn, this nigga just come off of surgery? Couldn't tell. So, Boston, you gotta come with your game faces on. I seen some shit that, So I'm watching the game. I'm watching the pregame before the game started, and I'm watching, I remember it was Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, and they were showing the warm-ups before the game, and I'm looking at the shirts they had on, Celtic Pride, and they got the little leprechaun they go on the joint. And the leprechaun little nigga is spinning the basketball on his middle finger. And I never noticed that before. I don't hate the Celtics. I'm a Lakers fan. I dislike the Celtics, so I'm not like a Celtics fan, like, you know. But that just took me back to game one of Boston and Brooklyn in round one. And when Kyrie was giving the Boston fans a middle finger and shit, that's ironic. But because that game one, that was the best game of the playoffs so far. Until today. Great transition. I'm good at this shit. Great transition. So Boston Brooklyn was the best game of the playoffs so far, that game one, until today. Motherfucking Golden State and motherfucking Memphis, M-Town. Man, this game was it. I mean, this could be the finals, Golden State and Memphis. I don't know if it's going to go four. I don't know if Memphis is going to get swept, which I'm about to get into, or if it's going to go six or seven. But the game of the day was, it was great. And fucking Golden State won by one. I think it was 117 to 116. Klay Thompson missed two free throws at the end of the game. And then Ja Morant missed a layup, you know, with seconds left. He could have won the game for him. But nonetheless, Ja Morant had an excellent game. Klay Thompson had a horrible game. I'm not going to blame him or fault him. Referees were horrid in this game. They were terrible in this game. Makes no sense. They fucked the game up. And I had a bet in $1,600. Well, no, I had two. One was for $1,600 even. One was for $1,255. What's that? $2,800, $2,700? Plus, I had a bet in for Ja Morant to get points, rebounds, assists over 41.5 for $180. That'd have been fucking $3,000 I had coming in. Ja Morant come through for me, though. My nigga, my favorite basketball player. But, the referees are terrible. Klay Thompson got an early foul trouble, so did Steph. Took Klay out of his game. He finished with 15 points, I want to say. He should have had more. Referees were terrible in this game. But overall, the game was great. It was excellent. It was everything. I mean, Draymond Green did some dumb shit, but really wasn't no dumb shit because he shouldn't have got ejected. They caught a flagrant two. It shouldn't have been a flagrant two, but... And maybe it get rescinded because it's playoff time and you don't want to have that lingering. Not in the second round, before you even got to the third round, because we remember 2016... Motherfucking Golden State against Cleveland, and KD and Bron got into it, and Bron told him, you know, Bron always telling him, motherfucker, Bron when I got the referee a couple months ago, and he got the referee and pointing the fan right there, talking crazy, whatever, but we remember Bron when he got fucking Draymond jammed up, and it was 3-1, and then Draymond was suspended for game. No, that was 3-1. He was spinning for game five. Cleveland won game six. Cleveland won game seven. Kyrie hit the big shot, whatever the case may be. Draymond, you got to be easy. But I will say this about Draymond. I don't think the shit was intentional. But that rallied the troops because Golden State was down at the time and Memphis was on one. But this game was everything, yo. I'm watching the game. I'm into it. Because I know I didn't get to watch a whole game for a while. So I'm into this shit. And I'm watching this shit right now as I speak. I'm watching what I'm talking about. First quarter. Desmond Bain. He didn't have a big game. He only had 9 points. But he get the ball. He fucking crossed Steph up. And when he crossed Steph up, Ja on the right wing, though. He ain't got nothing to do with the play. I got rewinded. Ja on the right wing. So when Bane crossed Steph up, Ja started doing the gritty and shit. I'm watching this shit. Okay, so it was 6:41 in the first. And the score was tied at 12. Bang, cross up Steph, boom. As soon as he crossed Steph up, Ja started doing the gritty and shit, right? And then when Bang shoot the bucket and make it, Ja started doing the gritty even harder, right? But for him to be doing the gritty, it's one thing for a nigga in the NFL to score a touchdown and do the gritty after score a touchdown. But Ja start doing this shit mid-play with the clock ticking, with the game in motion. Like, yo, I loved it, though. And maybe it's because Ja my favorite player. So, you know, and Ja, Steph, Luka, them are my favorite players. But Ja my favorite player, though. That's my nigga. I got to see him play in person this year. He put on the show for me. You know, he's box office. But for him to do that shit, yo, and I see this shit, and I'm like, yo, that shit turned me up. Like, I'm like, yo, game was early on. It was 12-12. I'm like, yo, this going to be one of them games, yo. This going to be one of them games you got to remember, like. And yo, that shit is, they lost the game by one. It was a tight game. But, yo, I don't know if people who've seen that shit viewed it how I viewed it, like, but for him to do that shit in the game, mid-play, that shit was everything to me. Like, yo, like, this new generation, not just basketball players, but young motherfuckers in general, you know, it's a lot of y'all do that I don't approve of, but I'm not God, I'm not here to judge nobody or anything like that in the third, you know what I'm saying? But that, I love that shit, yo. And once again, it's probably because of the job, like, It could have been anybody else. I probably been like, out of down on shit. Like, what the fuck, right? But I know one thing: if this was the '80s, late '80s, early the '90s, when Jordan was playing, when the Bad Boy Pistons was playing, when Larry Bird and niggas was playing, and the Lakers and all them, they wouldn't went for that shit. They'd have fucked y'all up. They'd have fucked John Moran up. Facts. But nah, though, it was a good game, though, man. It was a good game. Ja had an excellent game. He had like 34, 10 assists and 9 rebounds or some shit. He had 9 rebounds. Game was lit, yo. Jaren Jackson had the game of his life. This is another thing, like, I'm not expecting Jaren Jackson to have another game like that. Like, he was just throwing up threes. The business was going in. I think he had like 36 points. Game of his life. He's not going to have that again. I just don't see it. Like, and game 3 is on Tuesday. If motherfucking, if Golden State win game 2 and they going back to the Bay up 2-0, Memphis, you might get swept, and I hate to see it, but I ain't gonna cap though. Like, I got my money on Golden State to come out the West, so I'm rooting for Golden State because that's where I put my money at, and I can't. I'm not taking that back. I need that little couple hundred. Facts. I don't need it, but it's going to use for something. What happened to this nigga? This nigga leaking like a Puerto Rican. Keith Yandel, played for the Panthers, hockey player. What happened to him? He took a puck to the face? He lost some teeth and everything. Yeah, that shit with hockey, boy. Hockey, dangerous sport. You got motherfuckers skating on skates. This blade sharp and that shit. I seen a motherfucker one time. I forgot who it was, but some shit happened and he somehow the skate hit his throat. And it's a wonder it don't happen more often. Like, but I remember that shit. That shit hit his throat, yo. His shit started leaking like a Puerto Rican, yo. And he was lucky he ain't die, yo. Like, I forgot what player, like he wasn't no major player, like, but I remember when that shit happened, yo. Damn, hockey a dangerous sport. I love it, though. My second favorite sport after football. But, Memphis, you gotta win game two. And then game one was so lit, yo. You got John Morant's dad. He was kicking it with he was sitting courtside with Yo Gotti, motherfucking Moneybag Yo right there, like, you know, and they was showing so many sexy bitches sitting courtside, like, Memphis, I gotta go down there. I gotta get down to Memphis for a job for a Memphis game next year, cause the game I went to see was in Charlotte. And I'll go down to Charlotte and see them again. Like, I plan on seeing John Morant at least three times next year. In Charlotte, in DC. And I'm going to Memphis. Like, that's my nigga. Like, I got to go. Like, you know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck if they be Golden State or not. I'm definitely going to turn up with y'all. Like, that's my main man, yo. His pops cool. His pops look like Usher. His pops probably about my age. He turned up, you know what I'm saying? He like a celebrity now. T. Morant. He's sitting with Gotti and Moneybag, yo. And, you know, they having the time of his life, man. But, good game. Great game. Best game of the playoffs so far. It definitely, for me, it definitely beat the your Brooklyn and Boston game. Definitely did. If this is what the second round is gonna give us, I'm here for it. I don't know what's gonna happen with Dallas and Phoenix tomorrow. Should be a great game. Luka against motherfucking CP3. Devin Booker coming back. I'll be there. Oh, they just showed niggas get their teeth knocked out. Cole played for the Penguins. Then they start. Oh my God, I gotta rewind that shit. Yo, he took a puck to the mouth, knocked his tooth out. Sheesh. You ain't a hockey player if you ain't got a missing tooth. They say this nigga, his whole kitchen missing. I love sports show. Like, I'm just, I was thinking that the NFL draft was yesterday, day before. It was a 3-day event. I ain't really do no draft special because I didn't watch the draft. But I read up on it. I seen who went where and all that type of shit. I'm looking forward to fantasy football next year. I'm looking forward to football, period. Like, period, because football is king. Football is football. But, it's the hockey playoffs start tomorrow. Starting later than usual, usually start right after basketball. Or, matter of fact, it usually start right before basketball, like a couple days before basketball, but they pushed it, they had it pushed back this year, so basketball could get their shine, and then hockey could get their shine, and then the hockey playoffs is on TBS, TNT, ESPN, ABC, so all games is just there for everybody to view. The promotion is there because I've been seeing it, like, I mean, anyway, because my Penguins in it, we play the Rangers. Let's knock them off. Let's do it. Shit. Let's do it. Let's go. But yeah. I'm yawning. I'm tired, bitch. Time to go to sleep. Back to work tomorrow. Both jobs. The weekend was fun. But, damn. NBA second round playoffs, baby. It's going down like a well on a boat. And we had great basketball today. We had great basketball today. Ja Morant had an excellent game and a loss. Jordan Poole, I didn't mention Jordan Poole. Jordan Poole had 30-something, 31 off the bench. I want to say he had 31 off the bench. He didn't start. He won that game for Golden State. He had like 7 assists, 8 rebounds too. He was on everything. Steph Curry, I got to mention him. Steph Curry came up big on the defensive stop at the end of the game. He gave Ja Morant fits on that last play of the game. Steph Curry's not a defensive player. He's never going to be talked about as one of the GOATs in defensive. He's not that. But his defense was top of the line against Ja on that final play. No, I'm sorry. Not the final play, but a couple plays before that. Steph's defense on Ja was impeccable, you know. But yeah, Morant just missed the layup. He put too much on it. If he put a little less on it and that motherfucker hit the glass and but that ain't happened. But it is what it is. But thank you for tuning in, yo. This was another episode of Scores and Horrors, and just keep rocking with me, yo. It's only up from here. Facts.